a resounding round of applause for Professor Lily Valley. That was phenomenal. That was, you know, what you don't have, you can't give. That was him pouring himself out to us. And these are privileges we should not, you know, take for granted. So like I said, the slide will be forwarded to our emails. So in case you didn't register when you came in earlier, I would advise you put your details on that form so you can get the necessary information you need. I would have liked us to throw questions. I think I think we received some questions in the background already. So moving on now, without wasting our time, I'll just take a few comments from the iTable before we throw it open. Now, the next voice you will hear after I get on this microphone is the voice of no other person other than Ogbeni Fuad Oki. Let's celebrate this. It's going to be a good message in a few minutes. Let's put our hands together celebrating.
Thank you very much. Let me start by apologizing that I have told the engineer Magnus. Indeed, I was told about this program only 2 days ago. And already I have a commitment in Abuja, the National Consultative Forum, which is also speaking to leadership. It's holding today, and also being to be one of the speakers. So I'm trying to, since I don't have the luxury of a private jet, I really need to get myself to the airport on time. Secondly, I am more of a backroom worker, and I enjoy myself just being part of the crowd and not being exposed. Which he knows, unfortunately, he has done this, and I can assure you I'll pay him back. I would also want to allude to one thing. For those of you that are mentees, that this is the best season for us to talk about leadership. This is what this country needs. It is there for you not to drive those of us that are analog of the space, so that you of the digital age can take over and take Nigeria to where Nigeria really should be. You have all it takes. Some of you showed us during the NSAS debacle that you have organizational skills, that you have determination, and you see yourselves first as Nigerians, which we do. You also have empathy, which is key. But know something very clearly. Leadership is power. Power is leadership. None is served anarchists. You must train yourself and then grab it. Don't be deceived that you are leaders of tomorrow. If you refuse to pick up the gauntlet and reboot, your leadership aspirations and thoughts. A lot of you would like to be like the two engineers there. But you know what? They persevere. They learn. They continue to learn. Elijah is here, one of my old mentors. Until we get the OSHA out first, you cannot believe. And God will continue. of Lagos. You cannot have a better opportunity than what the engineer manuals and the technical teams avails you. You cannot. The problem we have in this country today is just one thing: leadership. Now, I want to challenge you that by the time this program will celebrate its first anniversary, we will have you as leaders that will have thousands of other mentees ready and willing to be leaders that will take our country to where it should be. On my own, I want to promise that I will always be here, I will always be there for you. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Every time I round of applause for Okay, why would he? Okay, I'm really sorry. Like, I understand I'm trying to process it, but I need to process it, I just have to accept it. But let's celebrate Ogoni Fuad Obi. And just when I was about feeling the picture, I just don't know how I was so fast, you know. Alright, that's awesome. Okay, moving on now, we have, wanting to mention that we have people watching online. We have dignitaries watching online. We'll also recognize them very soon. But before we do that, I'll just run through a few recognitions. We have with us here today HSC manager from Bluebeck Power Solutions Nigeria Limited, Mr. Julius Hartman. You're welcome, Mr. Julius Hartman. Please let's signify. Thank you very much. We have now Mr. Engineer Eugene Itua of IRSN, Regional Chairman, IRSN, Engineer Eugene Itua. Thank you. We also have Mr. Temetope Udele, QHAC Manager, BACC Technical Limited. You're welcome, sir. Thank you very much. We have Engineer Ensho Ayo, Manager, Project Development and Realization. You're welcome. Let's just okay. Thank you very much. Okay, Barbara, we have a lot of people watching online. Can you just...
We have a lot of attendees online, and we would like to recognize a very, very important people. Everybody is important, but we would like to recognize Mrs. Dominga Odebumi.
Mrs. Dominga Odebumi.
We'd like to celebrate Her Excellency Dame Abimbola Fashola. Can we celebrate her? Thank you for joining us. We'd like to celebrate Professor Ayodele. Can we celebrate him? We'd like to celebrate a very wonderful woman, Mrs. Bukola Banwas. She's the wife of MJ and Jamie Banwas. We love you very much, man. Can we acknowledge Dr. Wilson Agrippo? Please can we celebrate him? We'd also like to recognize Fumi Adebola. We'd also like to celebrate Victoria Debite. We'd like to acknowledge Mr. Edidion Ekanem.
Okay, I think I can see Mr. Femi Grasilva too. Let's put our hands together. So those are all, they are all watching online. They are connected to this event, watching online. We really appreciate you. Okay, we also have sitting here with us, Engineer Vincent Obaseki, Chairman, Nigeria Institute of Power Engineers, Lagos. Engineer Vincent Obaseki, we are glad to have you. We have Mr. Jelin Oladimeji, FCA. Let's put our hands together for Mr. Jelin Oladimeji. Ladies and gentlemen, we have Olushola Ogunleye, Chairman, Institute of Safety Professionals of Nigeria, Lagos Branch. You're welcome, sir.
We would like to acknowledge Engineer Tosin Ogunmola, who is present here with us. Can we celebrate him? He's the chairman of Ikeja Electric Branch. Can we celebrate him? He's a great leader of the engineering profession. Can we celebrate him, please?
Okay, we have
Engineer Dr. Bumi Kuka. Engineer Dr. Bumi Kuka. We have Engineer Kabir Abiodun. Engineer Kabir Abiodun, welcome. We have Engineer Tasi Udil of the NSC. Oh, the Deputy President, NSE. Let's celebrate him, let's celebrate him.
Also, we have Engineer Lola Adetono.
Engineer Lola Adetono.
The chairman is nice. We have Engineer
Babidele Idris. We also have
Engineer
Jide Ikunampai, the head of technical operations in Kenya Electric.
Mrs. Jolomi Tutu, the group director
of HSE in
IHS. Also, we have
Mrs. Fumi Olajide from Great Spring School. The best group director, I appreciate that.
Mrs. Folake Shoto to the CEO of Kenya Electric to give us a good message. Madam, please go ahead. All right. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm really delighted and excited to be here, and I'd just like to stand on existing protocols. Engineer Badmore set me up. Just, I don't know why he did this. He came to my office about 2 weeks ago and said, and told me about this dream and vision of his. And he said that he spoke about the program and what he wanted to achieve with regards to impacting younger people. And I was very excited about it because leadership is very key and important to me. And he said to me that on the 1st of October, I would like you to come. And I said, look, I have a lot of things that I'm going to do. And then I agreed that for the next session, I will come. But I wanted to surprise him. So I came. And I'm very big on time. So I came at 10 o'clock. And I sat just there. And then he said, I'll go to high table. I said, high table? I'll go to high table. You know I have other things to do. And he said, oh, no problem. Of course, they started calling my name and forced me to come to the high table. And of course, now I have to speak, which I wasn't planning to do. But as I sat there and listened to him speak again, to his vision and his the plan on how he wants to achieve or impact lives, I was very excited to stay longer. And I kind of extended my meeting, moving forward, that I was sitting here and just listening. I think that the 60 participants, I think that you are very blessed and lucky to be part of this. He's right. A lot of people tell us the theory of theories about leadership. But the truth is that if you have an experience like this that shows you practical ways to actually be a leader, then you should actually take it serious. Because I don't think you can get it better. Professor Leary is someone that I know and respect dearly. And he spoke about mentoring. And I am definitely a product of mentoring. I have different mentors. And I still have mentors that are teaching me different areas of my life. And mentors are not only people that are older than you or more experienced than you. Mentors are new people that are younger than you. So mentoring is not one way, it's not you just learning. Mentoring is also learning from people that understand things you don't understand. I call it reverse mentoring. So I just wanted to mention that. And I just wanted to give a tip with regards to how I think we should approach mentoring. A lot of times, people that have the opportunity to get people that, you know, make up time to mentor them, think it's only about them taking and receiving. One advice I would like to give you today is, if you have the opportunity to have someone decide to mentor you, you also think about how you can add value to that person. So if you have someone, earlier on, you know, you spoke about analog and digital. So if you're in the city category, definitely you'll be the digital, right? And if you have someone who is in the analog generation, I mean, then you can add value to them by bringing that skill you have in the digital space. So if you're a techie, help them be techie. Help them create awareness about their experience using digitalization, right? So I just thought that that's a charge and advice I can give you. That mentoring is not one way, it's two way. And don't think about yourself alone, but think about how you can make a difference or add a value to the person that is sacrificing to mentor you, because it's not an easy thing to do, especially for people that are busy and have tight schedules. Second thing for me that I'd like to just leave is, I think that's important that we are very deliberate. And I think it's important that we are very clear about who we are. So we should be self-aware. When I say self-aware, understand what your strengths are. Understand what your weaknesses are. And be very clear about what you want to enhance. And don't be afraid to focus on improving the areas that you're struggling. And also, if you're deliberate, you can actually do anything. You can do anything you put your mind to. I'm sitting down here in the midst of a lot of engineers. I work in an organization where it's technical in nature. I'm the engineer, and I'm not an engineer, but I'm the CEO today. When I come speak in my next session, I will explain practical things that I had to do to be in this role today. It's part of being deliberate. It's part of being determined to make a difference. So that is just my own advice. I think I've spoken too much. I'll stop at this point. Thank you very much, and thank you for the opportunity.
Let's put our hands together again. You better than Mr. Lakesh Shweta. We'll see you in Kenya next week. Thank you very much, man. So awesome hearing from you. Okay, I would like to recognize the presence of Mr. Dixon Osaji, a global security analyst. Mr. Dixon Osaji, so glad to have you with us. Okay, and the next person I'll be recognizing will be giving us a goodwill message. Is the representative of the DG Lagos State Safety Commission. Please put your hands together for Mr. Shehu Awojobi. You can do better, you can do better. Representative Director General of Lagos State Safety Commission. Keep clapping, keep celebrating. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Shehu Awojobi, and I'm representing the Director General of Safety Commission, who is unavoidably absent. And I will say, Tinajami also set me up for this. I feel privileged to be on this podium today, particularly because we're talking about leadership. And I'm also a young man, and currently the technical advisor to the Safety Commission. But I have three things to say, and I hope the mentee will take this from me. And one of it is, to be a leader, humility is key. And we can see that in the life of Engineer Jamil. I think everybody that has come here to speak about him has spoken about his humility. Now, humility will open doors for you where you never expect. Second thing is putting in the work. Oftentimes we believe that it will happen, it's luck. I don't believe in luck. I believe that I'm only lucky when I put in the work. And the results of my success is only a feedback of how much work I've put in. The third thing I would say is narrow your focus and it will help you broaden your horizon. Let's not do too many things at the same time. Sometimes knocking on a door continuously and constantly would break that ice. And oftentimes what we need is that ability to break the ice. Now, Professor Bale said something, and I wrote it down. He said, leadership is not a position, it's a mindset. To all the mentees, please, every day as you wake up, tell yourself, I will be what I choose to be. Nobody, living or dead, will take that away from me. And once you understand that, then you understand that you are moving to places. Ogbonifuadoji said something. He said, power and leadership go hand in hand, and they are not served a la carte. Also, on the final note, I will say, nobody is willing to relinquish power. Neither would leaders naturally leave their position. We need to be deliberate. And as Nigeria marks the first independence anniversary, I want to say to the young men here, which I am fortunate to be a part of, we need to drive that change. We need to drive inclusion. We need to see a better Nigeria. And every day I pray and I look for people that will join me in my cause. I'm in the public sector today. I intend to go far in the public sector. I intend to change the narrative of what Nigeria is about. I intend to be a good leader. And I want to join everybody, all the mentees here, to please follow me on this course and also charge them to have their own course. And I believe that we will have a greater Nigeria. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Shemo Awojobi, representing the Fiji Lagos State Safety Commission. Okay, very quickly, this is our time we're trying to speed up things. I would like to bring up Honorable Wale Bakari for his goodwill message. Let's celebrate it. Honorable Wale Bakari, get me louder, louder, louder. As we get ready for the next lecture.
All protocols to the end. Very good to see you again, madam. Right. Elijah, always good to see you. Everybody has said a few things about how Engineer Jamil corralled them, or yeah, of course, he did it to me as well. Right. But I was expecting it because that industry is doesn't take room for an answer, and you can't help but, you know, just do what he wants you to do, and that's the kind of leadership he's always shown from the very first time I've known him. And he's just an absolutely wonderful guy, and every time, any place he comes upon me, I just have to be there. I was actually supposed to be here for that, just about 13 minutes and began, but now the whole of my day has changed. Yeah, but very quickly, let me just say one thing, and I don't know if I'm talking to the mentees or the mentors here about leadership, and that is that for you to be able to effectively and sincerely move people to a place of their maximum actualization, for you to be able to impact on people to the best of your ability, you've got to come to an acceptance yourself, or to a place of comfort with who you are yourself. You've got to be able to not be, what's the word now? Not be concerned about the person you are mentoring or leading rising above you. And that's one thing that I see a lot of times is a challenge within these clients. You claim to be mentoring people or to be leading people, and you're afraid that they are going to quote-unquote outshine you. When the entire purpose of your leading them is so that they can outshine you, you can go beyond who you are. When you hear their names, when their names come up in public discourse, person becoming who he or she is. It should be something you share in vicariously, in their joy, in their achievement, and believe that, yes, I am, I mean, that is me that's celebrating on this. And once you are able to internalize that and you're able to see yourself from that perspective, then there's nothing you would want to contribute to that person getting to that position, just like your child or your son. You won't hold anything back from me because you're afraid that your son is going to rise higher than you are pleasing. So if you look at your mentee or the people you lead from that same perspective, then you can be sure that you will do everything that is humanly possible to help them rise and achieve their full potential. And that is what I've tried to do over the course of the few years that I've been in safety. Well, a few years now, not even 2 decades. But I mean, I know how many people, if I tell you what my formal qualification in safety is, a lot of people here are quite shocked, all right, what my formal qualification is. But up to today, I have people who are doing masters, who are doing PhDs in safety, call me up to seek advice, to seek for knowledge, to ask me how do I approach this thing, how do I do this thing, like Jamie talks about, Jamie likes to say, I've met people in at least across the African continent, not less than 10 countries, where they call me Walimu, which is Swahili for teacher. It's not because I got degrees in safety, just because of the way every single opportunity I've got to impart knowledge and doing to talk, to the best of my ability, not caring or not minding where that person that is listening to me is going to, because I wanted to go to where, I wanted to go to a position where every time he rises, he remembers that, that guy has something to do with it. And then, of course, over the years, I've also been quite a bit of a, I've been a little off it because the people there remember. Okay, so never be afraid that who you are mentoring or who you are leading is going to be better known than you, is going to be brighter than you, is going to be more important than you. That is what you want. You want to be able to leave a footprint that will not be forgotten. And you can only leave that in the hearts and in the lives of people that God brings into your way and that you are pursued to impact on who we are. I've got to leave now, and that's why I'm just saying this now. I hope that as this program grows, I'll be here to share more of my experience and more of my life with those that have been blessed enough to be selected to be part of this program. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you very much, everybody, Bakari. Okay, like I said, what we have left of the program, I'm just gonna shoot so that we'll know how to manage our patience very well. Okay, so just after we take one Google message from the internet, we just move straight into the next lecture, and after that, we have a networking session, and we'll call it a wrap. So ladies and gentlemen, we have Mrs. Fumi Adebola on standby, who wants to share a Google message online. Because our second speaker is pumped up, fully ready to shoot. And I want to squeeze, I don't know if we are taking notes at all, because I don't know. Let's celebrate her. So she will listen to her Google message before the next speaker. So let's hear from her.
Good afternoon. Is it afternoon now? Yes, it is afternoon. I hope you can hear me.
Yes, ma'am. At this junction, please, I would like us to control the movement as much as possible, please, because the next speaker will need our rapt attention, and please, any form of distraction will not be appreciated. Please, if you want to use the restroom, it's fine, but let's minimize the movements in the room. We are almost done. We know that you have a lot of activities. We are not time wasters. So please help us to make things organized as much as possible. Ladies and gentlemen, the life of my Mutala is an open book. In everything she does, she ensures that she exemplifies diligence, good team spirit, excellence, capacity, competence, dignity, integrity, vision, commitment, contentment, accountability, and unblemished character. She is indeed, according to Are Afe Babalola, S-A-N, a woman of substantial substance. Margaret Aino Ogutala, popularly known as the Renew of NSK, obtained a Bachelor in Engineering from the University of Benin in 1986. She is now a certified environmental consultant. She has also kept abreast of her career by attending various professional development programs, both within and outside the country. In another 6 years of postgraduate life, she has gathered experience in various fields of chemical engineering and management. Today, she is the MD/CEO of Bamstack Nigeria Limited, as well as managing partner of Bamstack Engineering Services Limited. Both companies are involved in environmental consultancy, fire and safety, and civil mechanical engineering services, respectively. Also, presently, Madam Margaret is the Executive Director of Kennel Nigeria Limited, Board Member of Black House Media Limited, Representative of Southwest Geopolitical Zone and Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, Kuren. She's a member of Government Council, Lagos State Polytechnic. She's a member of College Industry Board, Covenant University, Otta. Ladies and gentlemen, she's a three-term Vice President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. She has served the Nigerian Society of Engineers in various capacities in her 25 years of membership. She is the ninth chairman of NSE Ikeja Branch 2009-2011. At the national level of the Association of Professional Women Engineers in Nigeria, APWEN, Engineer Ogutala served as General Secretary, Publicity Secretary, and Technical Secretary at various times, between 1996 and 2004. She has also remained active in the Nigerian Society of Chemical Engineers since she joined in 1993 by serving in various committees. Ladies and gentlemen, she has been the guest speaker at various events, both engineering and non-engineering. She has over 56 awards and accolades to her name. She is happily married to engineer Theophilus Ogutala, FNSC, FNSCHE, and they are blessed with children and grandchildren. If your hands are not too busy, join me as I welcome engineer Margaret Aino Ogutala to the podium.
Thank you very much. You know when you are overwhelmed and what's failing you? I'm very glad to be here today. And I am indeed humbled by the accolades and all. I do not deserve that much. And I thank Engineer Jack Badmoss for bringing me here today. He actually did give me the chance of saying no. He just called me and talked about what he wanted to do, and then he said, I'm bringing you on 1st of October. So it looked impossible to me, because just about a few days ago I was in Abuja, and a few days before then I was in Asaba. And I told him, I said, no, for he didn't allow me to speak, he really did not. So here I am today, but I'm glad to be here. I mean, looking at the quality of people that I find here today, and the audience, I'm very glad that I agreed to come here. People that have no choice. So we are talking about leadership reboots and how we dwelling on ethical leadership, a necessity for every professional and top leader. Since we are raising top leaders, I believe that we should talk about ethics and how to raise ethical leaders. Yeah. of you. I'm going to start with a case study, and then I'll talk about what leadership is, which most of us know, and then, fortunately, Mr. Mary Badley has won a lot about leadership. Incidentally, I met him about 30 years ago, and at that time I was in with Pfizer. And so when I saw my name put side by side, I was kind of very excited, and I felt very humbled to be speaking side by side with Mr. Mary Badley. So we have spoken a lot about leadership, or we'll talk a bit about it. And I'll talk about leadership types and then ethics. Ethical leadership, tips of success, and more confidence. So I want to start with this case study. It's the story of a pilot, an American pilot. On January 15, 2009, in the way Nigeria was marking its armed forces remembrance day, a miracle happened in the United States of America. An Airbus A-220 aircraft carrying 155 people took off from Lagardia Airport in New York and lost both of its engines. Seconds after takeoff, to geese. It just ran into the sort of geese that were flying. And the flight at that time was less than 3,000 feet on the air. So, less than 4 minutes after its engines shut off, because when an aircraft runs into such fleet of winds, its engines will pack up. And in this case, both engines packed up. So, less than 4 minutes after its engines shut off mid-flight, flight 1549, which was the flight number, landed on the Hudson River. Which caught through New York, and all 155 people on board that flight were saved. The flight was later to be dubbed the flight miracle. So, what happened? The man behind the wheels, the pilots, called Captain Chelsea Soliberger, nicknamed Soli, was the one who made that decision. Who is a thought leader? A thought leader is somebody who can change the narrative or influence the narrative by showing and proving that he knows what to do, he understands what to do. So, Sonny was a very good thought leader. So, flight 1549 was just a routine flight, but ended up being one of the most talked about events in history. All thanks to the leadership of that captain, a thought leader indeed. So, as a thought leader, you must understand what to do. A thought leader is a person that is like a go-to person, someone who understands what to do at all times. So, today we are talking about thought leaders. Okay, so this is just a narrative of what happened, but the story either, or the end of the long and short of the story is that the captain, through a split second decision, landed on the river and was able to save all passengers. A few of them were seriously injured, but there was no fatality. There's another story that I want to mention, and that's the story of Rachel. Rachel works as a quality assurance engineer at a large electronics company, and she's responsible for the final testing of our company servers, which is a part of a team that decides when new products will be shipped to distributors for sale. Now, Rachel's company also has a contract with another company, which makes the chips which are incorporated into the server, that which Rachel's company is. The business model for this product is to release a new generation of server every 6 months. Which means Rachel had to ship, and then she had to do all her control tests within 6 months. Because there's such a short space of time between the release of each new product, the quality and assurance department cannot perform every possible test. Now, to be sure that the product is defective, she must wait 6 months. Yes, she has competitors. The company has competitors. And if she doesn't ship, the competitors will ship. Now, then comes an ethical dilemma. What does she do? Should she ship even when she knows that there might be defects just because she wants to beat her competitor to it, or should she not ship? So I thought I got this, should she or not to ship? So you will ask yourself, as an ethical leader, what would you do in under those circumstances? So now, what is leadership? Leadership is the ability of an individual or a group of individuals to influence and guide followers for other members of an organization. Another definition of leadership is the capacity of a company or management to set and achieve challenging goals. So a leader is somebody who must be able to set goals and achieve them. So you are not a leader unless you are able to achieve your goals. Anybody can set goals. We make on January 1st every year, people set goals for themselves. They may be the same, they call it New Year resolution. But those who actually achieve those goals are the ones that are can be referred to as leaders. And according to John Maxwell, a leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. So not only does he know the way, he goes the way. And it actually shows it. That means it's also mentoring, which Mr. Lebali has talked about. Now, these are styles of leadership. We have different styles of leadership. We have the autocratic leader, we have the transactional leader, the democratic leader, we have transformational leader, and these are all leadership styles. Now, what are the differences in all of this, or between each one of them? The autocratic leader, the autocratic leadership exists on the opposite side of the spectrum. Okay, autocratic is actually the opposite of democratic. You can think of this as my way or the highway. So this, the autocratic leader is the one who believes that his own way is the only way out. The democratic leader is the one that goes by the book. He says this is the way we do it. This is the way the textbook explains it. He doesn't want to think outside the box. He wants to do it just exactly the way the book explains it. And then they describe leadership. It's a French term that translates to liberty, which pretty accurately summarizes this hands-on leadership approach. These leaders provide the necessary tools and resources, but then they step back and let their team members make decisions. So this one goes to make decisions. They still leave you to make the decisions. And then they will have a charismatic leadership. Charismatic leaders have magnetic personalities as well as a lot of conviction to achieve their objectives. But rather than encouraging behavior through strict instructions, these leaders use eloquence and communication persuasion, you know, to unite the team around the cause. So they will get people together, you know, because of the special skills that they possess. And they don't get people to work together that way. We have the transactional leadership, we have transformational leadership. And the one that I would like to really talk about is the transformational leadership, which is the leader that seeks change, you know, and transformation in the business or group in which they lead by inspiring them, you know, motivating them. So these leaders are all about making improvements and finding better ways to get things done. So a transformational leader is the kind of leader that you want to be. The one that seeks a change in his follower and motivates him to change. We have the servant leadership, we have the democratic leadership. Those are just all forms of leadership. Like I said, the kind of leader that we need to breed now is transformational. So leadership, this is what leadership does. It empowers people. It inspires people and leads to change. And then with all of this, there's also a shared vision. You must have a shared vision with the people that you lead. And what are the qualities of a great leader? A great leader is somebody who knows about accountability. He's accountable for every deed that is every single deed, you know. And then he can listen, he knows how to listen. Active listening is a great asset of be able to collaborate. You must be able to, you must have courage. If you don't have courage, there are some decisions that you can't even make. Even when you know them and you recognize them. And you can't deal with the people living unless you have courage. Communication, you must have very good communication skills. You must have a growth mindset. There are some people who really don't know how this growth mindset. These are people who will lead you and not inspire you to grow. They just keep, like they are teaching you or coaching you at all times, but they don't really lead you. You must have a focus. You must have a goal and be focused. And then humility is very important. You can't be a great leader unless you are humble. You must be innovative, you must have an innovative mind, and you must be able to inspire people. At all times, a good leader must be able to inspire people, and then he must have strategic and critical thinking, really, at all times. Because there will be times when your thinking faculty as a good thing will be called upon. And if you don't have the ability of critical thinking, you will not be able to make quick decisions. And you must be flexible. You don't know it all, you don't have the answer to everything, so you must be flexible at all times. You must be able to take listen sometimes and bow to superior arguments. That's flexibility. You must be responsible, you must be dependable, and you must be authentic. You must have an open mind. Open-mindedness is very important. And you must have very good interpersonal relations with people. You must be resilient, and you must have a knack for problem solving. So these are the qualities of a great leader. These are the things that make a great leader. Now, how about ethics? Because that's now we need to relate ethics with leadership. The word ethics originates from the Greek word ethos, meaning character. So ethics are a set of rules or principles that are generally considered as standards of good or bad or right or wrong, you know, which are usually imposed by external group. So ethics are rules that are imposed on us to guide us in our character, to guide our character, to guide our behavior, to guide us in everything that we do. And can be understood as the rules of conduct proposed by society. For instance, the United Society of Engineers has its ethics. We have ethics of engineering practice, and I'm sure we have that for every other profession. And generally, in every society, there are ethics and conducts. As professionals, we are expected to exhibit the highest standards of honesty and integrity because our profession has a direct and vital impact on the quality of life. So, as a professional or as a leader, we have to maintain very high standards and of honesty and integrity. And it's when you have those standards that you are called an ethical leader. Aristotle emphasized the practical importance of developing excellence, you know, as the way to achieve what is finally more important, excellent conduct. So if you don't have developed excellence in character, you can never have an excellent conduct. So ethical leadership and thought leaders. Ethical leadership means that individuals behave according to that set. So we are ethical leaders if we behave according to the set of rules that are laid down by the society. And this includes integrity, respect, trust, fairness, transparency, and honesty. Those are usually the rules of ethics. Thought leaders are the informed opinion leaders, so, and the go to people which I mentioned earlier. And so, because you are trusted, a trusted source, you are expected to inspire other people to be honest and to have integrity as a leader. And then your status as a professional and thought leader means you have high moral responsibility to integrate ethical leadership into your actions, your thoughts, and your conduct. Because the people that you lead must see you as an example and a good role model. So I want to, yes, this quote from the Hub. If you look to lead, invest at least 40% of your time managing yourself. And that's your ethics, your character, your principles, your purpose, motivation, and conduct. invest at least 30% managing those with authority over you and 15% managing your peers. So when you look at this, you actually need more time managing yourself than you do need managing other people. So there's another case for you here, and this is the story of Victor. Victor is an engineer in a large construction firm, and he has been assigned the task of being the sole person to recommend repairs for the construction of a large apartment building. After some research and testing, he decided to recommend Ahmed for the job. Ahmed being the lowest in cost and actually the highest in standards and quality. But on the day after Victor's decision, an Ahmed representative visits him and gives him a voucher for an all-expense paid trip to the annual Ahmed Technical Forum, which meets in Jamaica, all the way from Jamaica, all the way from America. The trip, though, will have considerable emotional value, will also provide great trips to the beach and other points of interest. So the question is, if Victor assesses, has he been bribed? Do you think he has been bribed? So why do you think he has been bribed? Okay, in the next slide, we'll look at reasons why he may have been bribed. Now, the point is Victor faces a moral dilemma, or ethical dilemma. Why is judgment and awarded the contract may not have been influenced by the gifts, gesture, future decisions made? That means even though he had made the decision before he gave the voucher, it was time for that moment, for whatever future. His future decision may be influenced by the fact that he had got that all experience being true. There is no question mark of Victor's finding mental technical ability because he chose the best in quality and the best in price. But there's a big question mark on his leadership traits as regards integrity. Imagine the subordinates. I mean, Victor is a leader. So imagine these those subordinates that have it. What would they do? So as a leader who has no influence on what is in the offering, there will be suspicion on the subordinates in the business. What I'm trying to say is that if you were the leader and your subordinate did that, you would wonder, you would suspect that because that they have been promised that voucher. Even before you made this decision, you will forget the fact that the decision was actually the best at that time. So that puts a question mark on his ability to withstand temptation and discharge his duty without influence, which is about being an ethical leader. And in the same way, when someone else are watching the leader's action, they may believe that it was influenced by the gifts and not be a wrong signal that they subsequently lead to wrong future actions. So if they feel it, so what they feel that that's the way, okay, I'm taking this one, so me too, I can take my own, you know, the next time. So at the end, what happens in the end, the company suffers for it, everybody suffers for it. So for one mistake. So from an organization and community perspective, leaders can inspire those around them to behave ethically. So your behavior is what will inspire your followers. And through setting examples and giving direction for ethical behavior, others will observe and act similarly. As somebody asked me a question earlier, that okay, what happens when you are about the only person who is talking about ethics and work? Every other person is looking the other way, and you feel that you must do the correct thing. So what do you do in a situation like that? And I said that you need to focus in what you believe in. You'll be surprised how many people are looking at you. Apart from the fact that you are building a good reputation for yourself, other people are looking at you, and they're using it. They'll use you as an example. Especially on a personal basis, they will look at your credibility, and then it will affect your personality and the way people, nobody will want to refer you if they do not believe that you are ethical. As a mentee, for instance, Mr. Larry Barnes spoke about your mentor also referring you as being your sponsor. But who wants to sponsor somebody who is not who is of low integrity, who wants to talk to somebody who is not ethical. So behaving unethical can be heavily damaged in that personal or company pride as well. And unethical behavior often results in low self-esteem, low output, because people will see you, and once they notice for that, then you are attacked, and then of course, what follows? Low self-esteem, low output, and then you have a lot of missed opportunities, no reference. So there are some ethical issues that we usually have in society, and some of them are discrimination. There's harassment. You know, there are all kinds of discrimination. Ethical, especially here, these days we have a lot of discrimination in terms of ethnic discrimination, religious discrimination, gender, and all kinds of discrimination. Those are ethical issues. And an ethical leader should not be found doing any of those. And then harassment. The leader, an ethical leader should not be involved in harassment of any kind. Corruption, of course. We just talked about Victor. Health, safety, and environment violation. You don't do that. If you do that, you are contravening the ethical law. Abuse of leadership authority. There are people who really just don't have respect for authority. That's also unethical. It's an ethical issue. Nepotism, favoritism. Somebody is due for promotion and you don't give him because it's not your. If he doesn't know too, or he doesn't bow at every point to you, you feel that you should not give a promotion that he deserves, or recommend him for a promotion as it were. Then corporate espionage is a really serious ethical issue. Copyright concerns, profits, over profits, a lot of people place a premium on profits and they forget everything that came. Corporate fraud, of course. Failing to cooperate with others is unethical. Hiding critical files from colleagues. You must share knowledge. A good thought leader is one who is also willing to share his knowledge with others. And then tarnishing fellow professionals' images is also very unethical. There are a lot of people who don't do anything other than tarnish other people's images. So, this slide is not talking about ethical and professional conduct. And I think we'll talk a lot about ethics and the professional conduct as it applies to every profession and indeed the life of everyone. Next slide, please. So, these are many things of ethical leadership. You have ethical leadership skills, which are physical for professional engineers, especially engineers working in a global context. I chose to use engineers because that's my profession, so I chose to zero on that. And then, if you have the skills of ethical leadership, or you are an ethical leader, you are likely to win the loyalty, if you are more likely to win the loyalty of both your employees and your clients as a leader. And then you have less stress and improve emotional well-being. Because you are doing all the correct things, you don't have to look and we watch your back all the time or look at your shoulder at all times, wondering whether people are seeing you or not. There's no bad PR for your company or yourself. And then the morale of your employees or your followers is improved when they work with you as an ethical leader. These are important skills for ethical reasoning. I mentioned what you need to do, the qualities of an ethical leader. I just want to dwell a bit more on the important skills that you require for ethical reasoning. Moral reasonableness. So, most of the ethical issues are actually also moral issues. So, how reasonable are you in terms of morals? Do you have respect for persons? If you do have respect for persons, then you are not likely to do things that are unethical or behave in unethical ways towards them. Then you must be tolerant of diversity. You must be able to tolerate other people. Communication is something that I mentioned earlier. You must be able to communicate well. And you must have integrity. You must have an open mind. Open mindedness. You must be transparent at all times. And ethical leader is always transparent because with the ethics tree, you can see that, you can see all the skills that you need there. Integrity, value, honor, conscience, fair play, responsibility, principle. You know, all these things are skills. All these are skills for ethical reasoning. Now, what are the tips for success? To be a successful ethical leader, you must define and align your values. Treat others the way you would like to be treated. You must hire people with similar positive values, traits of integrity, honesty, and so on. If you attempt to be an ethical leader, and then you surround yourself with people who do not have similar values, then you are likely to run into problems later. Encourage open communication among team members. There are times when somebody just needs to ask the question, what do I do in this situation? But if you are not approachable, or you don't have a good open communication line, then your team members do not ask the question, and they will make mistakes. Admit your faults and improve on them when outdated. Lead by example. Remember, actions matter more than words. Find role models. So look for people who you would like to be, who you would want to be like, and behave like them. Provide appropriate training that drives you know the essence of ethics. Develop your emotional intelligence. Help people learn from their mistakes. Support those who are affected negatively by personal and family pressure. But if you show understanding to them and support them, you may be able to save them from falling into temptation. You may just be able to offer them some advice that will give them some support. And that also means that you must be empathic. You must have empathy for your team player, your team, or your followers. Then you must show leadership in every opportunity of daily activities. So you don't show leadership only when people are watching. It must become a part of you. And in conclusion, implications of ethical leadership is universal. Even though your professional practice presents a main challenge, your words and actions may affect more than just your organization, and they can also influence public safety and the environment. Like Captain Sule, we will find ourselves sometimes in a position where our decision, words and actions can impact the life of other people. Like Victor, it may seem to be an indirect test of our integrity. What do we do? Therefore, every professional and thought leader must equip himself with leadership and ethical skills and make it a part of his daily practice until it becomes ingrained in him and those around him. As we mark this year's Independence Day, we must all resolve to play our part. While we look up political leaders to provide political leadership, we must recognize that each and every one of us is also a leader in his own way. Therefore, the responsibility to change our country is in our hands. We must integrate ethical leadership in our dealings in order to collectively build the Nigeria that we desire and deserve. And on this note, I say thank you very much for listening. I thank the organizers for the opportunity, and I thank you for the rest
of you. You can do better.
Wonderful.
Mommy, Barbara, come so that the Yahoo just adopted a new mommy today.
All right, you can have a seat.
Oh, wait a minute.
I have something to add to my gallery. You know, I have no strings. But sometimes, in Nigeria, there's this cliche that is very popular. You know who I am. People use that phrase everywhere in this country. Any small thing, someone just needs your guy. You know who I am. So when people need to be especially for someone like me, I'm not on the light side. I just give you my gallery. I'll just be scrolling. President, vice president, I'm sorry, sir. I don't know if he's still around. Can he step out? He's a thing of joy. Those guys are really, very brilliant guys. Okay, quickly, I'll take questions. We don't want to waste your time. I'm about 20, 25 minutes for calling around. But please, the remaining few minutes we have for this event, I want us to see how we can maximize it. It's been big, big, big today. Please, let's celebrate now one more time. Thank you very much, man. We really appreciate it. So all you can write down your questions, so that will form like the closing part of the event before we get into networking. So now it's time to just take a very short goodwill message from Elijah Arogodade. Let's bring it together for her. We can do better, better, better.
With more freedom in my heart and everything. I feel are we one of those? It is something that's really, and we have over 100 of us in this room, if I'm right, and some are on the internet and watching those on the Zoom. If we all resolve, we talk about that, yes, I am ready to start the leadership. Make sure that safety and health in this country is given the attention is needed. We will all contribute and take it to the highest point that, yes, it will be one of the most respectful and responsible profession in this country. We shall take it there. Please, let us all be responsible. Emotion, we can't control it, but our behavior, our attitude, just as said by the lecturer, is very important, and that will define us. On this note, I say congratulations to the motivator of this program, the organizer. Congratulations to all of us that have the opportunity to benefit from it. And more congratulations, big congratulations to any of us that will be able to use knowledge and impact on others and places we are working. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Until I got to live. I knew that I've been missing. I should have accepted it.
Thank you very much. I think that's more of a feedback that those who are
this point, we have to move on. Barbara?
Yes, before we come to a close, we'd like to invite two people very, very briefly to give us their brutal message. Can we welcome Engineer Obasi, who is the chairman of the Nigerian Institute of Power Engineering?
Engineer Obasi, chairman of the Nigerian Institute of Power Engineers, Ikeja. Please, let's put our hands together. So we just take those football messages shortly, shortly, then we close the event.
Who is a good leader? Before I go further, let me acknowledge the lecturer of today, Madam. Nice meeting you. And the motivator of today, I call him the Agaba of Safety, that is Engineer Badmus. And thank you, everybody. Who is a good leader? I believe if I ask the question, everybody would like to raise his or her hand that all of us are a good leader. But a good leader is a serious business. But in our own country, Nigeria, it may not be a serious business. But in the Western world, a good leader is a serious business. Why did I say so? To be a good leader in our country, Nigeria, it is not an easy task. Some of us who are privileged to be there, we know what is going on. There are so many factors that would like to draw you back. Some elements drawing sedimentary forces back for you to be a good leader. So it's not an easy thing. But with the rebooting of leadership today, I think we can do better. And I just want to advise those who are willing to be a good leader in our country Nigeria must sit down and hold on to it. But it is very easy if you listen to what the lecturer of today, both online and physically, and so many other conclusions today. If you listen carefully, I believe we will make a good leader, and being a good leader, you have a positive impact to move this country forward. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. All right, so finally, at the movement section, I'd like to invite Engineer Tosi Obumola, Chairman, NSE, Ikeja Brand. Let's put our hands together, everybody. You can celebrate better, you can celebrate better.
Thank you very much. Of course, because of our time, we have no choice than to stand on the existing protocols. But that will be without acknowledging my leader, who happens to be the guest lecturer here today. She was in this very position I currently occupy some 11 years back. So thank you so very much, ma'am, for continuing to lead us on. I most sincerely appreciate Engineer Badmus for this great platform that he has created to engage us as Nigerians on what I consider as the core of our nation. We all continue to allude to the fact that Nigeria seems to have it all but leadership. And the truth of the matter, like I always tell people, there is no problem without a solution. But I think for me as a person, as a matter of fact, while I appreciate everything about today, and I particularly appreciate the fact that yes, it is coming from the standpoint of health, safety and environment, but in all of this, there is just one key thing for me, and that is leadership. I have been a lifelong, self-driven student of leadership. So it is something very dear to my heart. But for me, as a Nigerian, I can say that one of the reasons we have not taken benefits from leadership, one of the reasons why we have not been able to actually turn a corner with leadership is because we do not exactly have the clarity. I do not have much of the time today, but But I would just want to say two key things that I would like that we walk away with. And that is the fact that leadership starts from you where you are. You do not have to think. Anytime we hear leadership, our minds go straight to President Buhari. Our mind goes straight to Governor Sanwo-Olu. But the truth of the matter is that leadership starts with you where you are. Now listen to this. If you do not become a leader before you get the position, it is difficult to be a leader in the position. So by the time we continue to complain about them here, that is not where the solution is. The solution starts with you and I. It is only as we all each become a leader where you are. That is where you can now be a leader when you have the position. So I want to encourage us all as we celebrate 61 years. The truth of the matter is that if you like it or not, the years will keep counting. But we must not make a decision. We want this year to count positively for us. In 10 years' time, when we'll be celebrating 71, what will be my own contribution? And the starting point will be where I am today, become a leader. So by the time you get this government position, one more thing again, don't forget, like I said, if you don't become a leader where you are, if you don't become a leader before you get the position, it is difficult to be a leader in the position. One more thing that I would like us to take away, because it is not enough. You know, a number of programs are ongoing today. Many of us, you know, I won't like to mention names, you know, on this platform, but several of you watch on TV. Enough of the talk shows, apart from the issue of clarity that I talked about, the other thing is about taking steps about it. I want to urge Engineer Chairman and the rest of us that are stakeholders within now, you know, starting off this. What are the action steps that we can begin to take? One came to my mind when I was on my way here, that can we as stakeholders facilitate the articulation of a curriculum on leadership, and we begin to teach leadership subjects even from the primary school. It is a fundamental issue, and you know, it is something that can be taught. Because like I said, but for the moment of time, there is one book I would recommend that we all go and read. That book is by Robin Sharma, and it is called The Leadership Without Title. The Leader Without Title. It was talking about somebody who is a cleaner in the hotel, but because she is a leader, even as a cleaner, she was impacting the bottom line of her business. A cleaner, she doesn't attend the executive meeting, but she was a leader as a cleaner. So there are a whole lot of issues about it, but again, I want to say for emphasis, if you don't become a leader before you get a position, it is difficult to be a leader. So when you say about leaders, don't complain about them. What you don't have, you cannot give you. So make effort now to have it. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, at this juncture, I would like to take the closing remarks. It's been a beautiful day here today, doing this alongside the delectable and beautiful Barbara. Please join me as I invite the safety advocate family, Azambi Azan, Ambassador Comfort, and Engineer Ensho to take the closing remarks. So please, let's present together for them. Keep celebrating them, the safety advocate family, Azambi Azan, Ambassador Comfort, Engineer Ensho. Please come forward for the closing remarks. And I learned that the organizers want to present a few hours, right? Just after this closing remarks. Please, after the closing remarks, just take 1 or 2 hours, then you can network, move around, say hello to someone, and push your brand to the next level. All right, the safety advocate family, can we?
Thank you very much, everyone. Standing on existing protocol permits me to say I'm wowed. The safety advocate family are wowed. We really appreciate your presence here. We thank all our leaders for taking out your precious time to come share those insightful teachings, leading by example from your prophet. I could read that and become somebody. So thank you very much. And to the motivator, my father in the safety industry, the engineer Jamiu. Father, I'm proud of following your steps. On that note, all participants, all leaders here, some of you are born leaders, some of you are on the journey, and some of you are about to take over. Whatever you find that is good, whatever you learn that is good, stay on that path. And as you go home, spread the good news of leadership. I'm sure that you are the change in your immediate community. Some people may not be here, but you being here will be the change they need. So thank you very much for honoring this invitation. And as you go home, may God grant you joining mercies, and see you next time. God bless you.
Thank you, my colleagues from the Safety Advocacy and Empowerment Foundation, the leading NGO in the country. I celebrate you all. That we will not wait to have the class to guide and every of us are going. We recognize and we thank all our leaders from the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Thank you, a lot of family. Thank you, online. And the network was not too good. He was flying from Abuja. That was the time. He was just kind here. I'm going to Lagos. I think this was my mentor and my father. And we thank the family of Society of Engineers. We thank the family of safety professionals. Eastbourne, we appreciate you. My brother, the Eastbourne Chairman Lagos, you are highly celebrated. It's a journey that you have just started with your new leadership. And this leadership we are talking about, we need to reboot leadership of organizations. So thank you very much. You are Zapan, good job, confidence. Mr. Megani Paka, the former and senior manager for NTN and Safety, we celebrate and recognize you. The Environment and Safety Volunteers, which of course, the initiative of Institute of Environment and Safety Management Institute. My brother is a member of the class and I appreciate you all. The Nigerian Institute of Power Engineers, where I'm also a member, I celebrate Engineer Obaseki. You have been very thorough and very supportive of everything you have been in this sector. You see, if I continue to mention this, you will not stop. The wife of the Minister for Housing, Work and Housing, that is Dame Abimbola Fashola, logged in from morning and she's still there. We appreciate you, Mama. She's the chairperson of LEN. Since she was as the wife of the governor, as a first lady, she has been doing that project. After first lady, she's still doing the same project till this year. Let's give her a round of applause. That is first leadership. Mama has been here this morning, which is just a wonder to most of us. I remember during the period of COVID, and people are giving palliatives. Much of it, all of us that have status under our program, they send palliatives to us. Plenty palliatives, they use money to bring it. My own came when all my staff are in there, and I said, but I'm going to be palliative. I just said, see, Mama, I'm going to take palliative. You know, that is the kind of person, women are very good. You have that compassionate leadership. And leadership is very different. That's what we need. Leadership is with empathy. That you put yourself in that shoe and see what it is. Women, they have that. So I celebrate all women in the world. I celebrate the first country to come out of COVID-19. That is Jacinda, the Prime Minister of New Zealand, a woman, was the first to come out of COVID-19 with good leadership. Go and get COVID-19 video. That's last year. Countries that came out are all governed by women.
but you know the motto, for the men, they are taking palliative.
Men are busy sharing palliative.
I must join this presentation. But it is good to be a good person.
All the three, to and fro, hotel, everything. I don't mind for you.
the whole world, and I was a speaker too, by virtue of being a risk manager in Nigeria. So I went to defend it there. When I was in the embassy, that was there, I was asking my sister, I'm ready to tell you. He said, when I get the dream, he said, I want to go here. And that alone is to be able to speak to people over the world. If you don't give this idea, bro, it's not a problem.
Awesome.
Yeah, my brother, please, yeah, my brother, my brother.
Thank you.